time I get the scary music, like I need to run away and I can't see anything, and then I can hear something screaming, but there's no scary music. Hi, welcome back to the Palaeocast Gaming Network. I'm Caitlin, and today I'm going to be looking at Saurian. This is Saurian, and it's a game where you can play as a dinosaur and live in a realistic ecosystem for 66 million years ago in North America. Eventually, you'll be able to play as a Tyrannosaurus, a Triceratops, or a Pachycephalosaurus, and at the moment, you can play as a Dakota Raptor. You can see this classic sickle claw here, which indicates to you that it's a dromaeosaur. So closely related to the velociraptor, more closely related to Utahraptor specifically. And also lots of feathers on this dinosaur, which is very good for a modern game. So let's just choose random difficulty casual and start the game. Okay, here we are in the world of Saurian. You start the game as a juvenile of whichever species you've picked, so in this case we're a juvenile Dakota Raptor. You can see one of the parents over there. There should be another one floating around somewhere. The way that the game starts for Dakota Raptor is that you have a couple of siblings, you have two parents, but as you probably can see in that little text box explainer up there, the game's designed in a way that Dakota Raptor parents aren't going to look after you. They're not necessarily going to immediately kill you, but you certainly don't want to get in their way because they're not going to care for you as much as other dinosaurs might. So we are running around North America, specifically the Dakotas, Montana, Wyoming sort of area. 66 million years ago, this is what it would have looked like. There was a giant inland sea in the middle of North America 66 million years ago. It was called the Western Interior Seaway, and it split the country into an eastern portion and a western portion. And in this game, we're in the western portion in Laramidia. The east was called Appalachia. So in the game, you have a green bar to indicate how hungry you are, a blue bar for thirst, and a red bar for your health, as well as a stamina meter. So the game really is just about surviving, what you need to do day to day. So that was drinking water, eating food, obviously, not getting killed by other animals. It's a pretty important one. And just trying to go through all the life stages of that dinosaur. So a couple of days will pass in-game, and then it lets you progress to the next stage of life of that animal, just so you can see what it's like and you don't have to actually play for years. So the feathering on these Dakota Raptor is based off fossil bones of their arms, so specifically the ulna, which is one of the bones in the forearm, because you have the radius and the ulna in the forearm. This ulna had little... how could I describe it? Little divots or dents that you would commonly see on an animal that has feathers, because the attachment sites for those feathers goes into the musculature of the arm, and that musculature leaves a shape on the bone as well, the way that everything sort of fits together. So the assumption, apart from the fact that many other dinosaur fossils have been found with feather impressions, and birds are dinosaurs, so we know that feathers had to appear at some point in this family tree. That's the reason why these animals are drawn with feathers. That's a little ferocious roar kick you can do as a juvenile. Alright, doesn't look like my parents is going to find us some food anytime soon, so I'll use the scent button to try and find something to eat. If there's any food around, it should light up in a bright color with it. Ooh, I can see some dinosaurs over here. I think it said Montosaurus. big herbivore in any case. Oh, wonderful, the ground even shakes when you're near them. So, if I'm not mistaken, and I definitely don't want to get underfoot of these guys, they won't attack me. I'm too small and not important enough. But they might accidentally squash me. So these are Edmontosaurus annectans. I think the game calls them Anatosaurus, but it's a little bit complicated. But I can provide some links if anyone's interested in the Anatosaurus versus Edmontosaurus argument. I think the devs had said at one point, because it's millions of years between Edmontosaurus fossils found in Edmonton, obviously, and these fossils found in the Hell Creek Formation, which is what covers Dakota, North Dakota, South Dakota, Wyoming, Montana. They said, well, it must be a different species because there's millions of years different. You wouldn't have, speciation doesn't work like that. You wouldn't have the same species lasting unchanged for millions of years. But that's not true. I mean, definition of species is a bit of a wobbly one anyway. We're talking about Edmontosaurus, which is the genus, not annectans, which is the species. There's a 2011 paper that looked at the shape of Edmontosaurus skulls and Anatosaurus skulls and found them basically to be very, very similar, probably different stages of growth of those animals, and that they actually do all belong to Edmontosaurus. So I'm going to go with these are Edmontosaurus and not Anatosaurus. So some of these dinos have got purple and red on their heads and others don't. Although there's no difference in size. So sexual dimorphism is essentially when the sexes look different in an animal species. So whether we're talking about sheep and goats where the males will have big horns and the females don't, or spiders where the females are much larger than the males. In a lot of animals, you can get a colour change to indicate the sex of that animal, but the body size stays the same. And again, it's artistic license, and that's what I like about this game. Oh, we've got somebody in the water. So there aren't just dinosaurs in this game. Of course, there wouldn't be just dinosaurs in any ecosystem during the Mesozoic. There are, as we can see over here, some sort of reptile. It could be a crocodilian or an alligatoroid. Or it could even be a champsosaur, which is very crocodile and alligator looking, but it's a completely different type of animal. Still a reptile though. I might. It's pretty dangerous choosing to go into the water to investigate because obviously, God, they're much quicker in water than I am. Go, 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 oh my God. So a very narrow snout, it flares out a little bit at the tip of the snout. But the key here is Champsosaurus didn't have the body armor that crocodiles and alligators do have. So scutes or osteoderms, so the bone armor, so it's literally bone in skin, osteoderm is bone skin. So these really hard square or rectangular, well, of course it's hard, it's bone. Square or rectangular pieces of bone that are embedded into the skin and into the musculature of crocodiles and alligators today, and was present in crocodiles and alligators in the Mesozoic. Champsosaurs, however, didn't have this sort of bony armor. So he's a pretty smooth looking boy, so I think that is a champsosaur. As you go through the different life stages, oh no, that's not good music. What's after me? Oh, I don't like that at all. I'm just going to pick a direction and run. Oh, Nithobimids. You know, it's scary. Maybe these are Struthiomimus or Nithomimus. Oh, and they're crossing the river. So, herbivorous. These are herbivorous dinosaurs. They had a sort of a beak. Oh God, that one nearly ran me over. They have a beak. Not a beak, but they had toothless jaws. Beak-like sort of structure. jury's out on whether the ornithomimids found at Hell Creek are Struthiomimus, Ornithomimus, or something else. But they've still put them into the game because they're obviously quite an enigmatic animal. Presumably the climate was pretty mild because you do see a lot of crocodilians, alligatoroids. Oh no, what's that? Could it be a tyrannosaur? Could it just be another Dakota raptor? How come I get the scary music like I need to run away and I can't see anything and then I can hear something screaming but there's no scary music? Okay. Here's something I can eat. It's not actually lighting up as a scent. A small bird. Oh, I went to run at it to kill it. There we go. Again, alpha game. Pre-alpha game. That is okay. At least I get a bit of a meal now. I was nearly starving to death. So that is some good luck. Now, what is this? Oh, I wonder if it's one of the little mammals. I know there's Dicynodon. Not Dicynodon. Didelphodon, sorry. In this game. Oh, the game's going to let me advance to the next growth stage if I want. But yes, I think this is Didelphodon. Yep, so one of the ancestors of our mammal lineage. Placental mammal lineage. I was actually... They're Metatherians, so this is before you get to the placental mammal group, which we're included in. So animals that have a placenta, animals that get pregnant and not monotremes that lay eggs, not marsupials. I'm not sure if these guys would have laid eggs or given live birth. No, there have been some fossils found of them with hatchlings. Well, not hatchlings, again, I don't know if they hatched out of eggs or not, but lots and lots of tiny little babies. Really small in body size compared to the parents, so whether that means they were in tiny eggs or just born really early in their growth stage, I don't know. Maybe I should stop harassing this Didelphodon and advance to the next stage of life. So I can press the crouch button and then hold that down to go to sleep. Well, that was Saurian. I really love this game and I'm so glad I was able to share it with you. Let me know what you think, and as always, keep an eye out for more paleontology-themed games on the Palaeocast Gaming Network. Bye!